Thank you. Thank you. Coming up quick. Job, Journey, go, Journey, go! Stay with it, Journey. Look upfield.
Thank you. thank you for coming out to the 21st Friendship Game. Always a hard-fought contest. Had a lot of fun. You know, you're friends for 2 weeks, and then you got to go out here and bang heads, and it was a very exciting, well-played match. So I congratulate both teams. Metro Girls, you've gotten better with every game. You're a strong team, and I know you're going to go back to England, and you're going to show people what the game of lacrosse is, just as you did before you got here. But you're a tremendous team, and I know you guys have very bright futures ahead of you, and you were well coached by a wonderful staff there. So congratulations on your our team. You got a great bunch of kids to spend the summer with. Outstanding kids, you know, examples of the best that Anne Arundel County has to offer. So thank you for all your efforts, and you played great. You came out to play tonight, and we're very proud of you. And also thank you to our developmental team who worked the sidelines today. It was great. Everybody hydrated, cold cloth, you know. In case you weren't, you're still under consideration for next year, so that helped a little bit. So. Still provisional. The refs, two of the best refs in Anne Arundel County. We have Lee and Jen here tonight. Where are they?
Here.
Are they? Thank you very much. Thank you for you. Our official tour shirt of 2016, we hope you wear it with pride. Thank you very much. Hold on, Susan. Hold on. You know, there's an undeniable bond between our two communities. Started in 76 with the boys tour, continued on when the girls side joined in 1996. A lot of great friendships have been made. A lot of great lacrosse has been played. And if you think it's big here, you should see it over there. You go into the family's home, and right there with their kids and their grandparents' pictures are the little trinkets that we give them as gifts or pictures of the kid they hosted. And it's a really big deal. They play a real high standard of lacrosse over there now, and it's always a joy to go over there. It's like going home. And the standard of lacrosse is in no short measure for the people right here coaching. They do a wonderful job, and we really appreciate the association for here today. Thank you very much for being a great guest and being great hosts when we go over there. Obviously, there's a lot of people to thank with this endeavor, and we should start off with the parents. You've opened your homes. Fed and entertained our guests from England, and you've just given them a memory of a lifetime. So we thank you for that, but you know, it's we choose the kids. We don't just choose the athlete, we choose the families. And once again, you guys represent the best of Anne Arundel parents. So thank you very much for that. There's also some special thanks for people who provided us with very good food at our events. They kind of went above and beyond, took a leadership role in the alumni game and now the friendship game. And Mrs. Driggs and Mrs. Stickle, thank you for stepping forward and preparing their and also Doug Fortner and Shecky Rose. Is Shecky Rose here tonight?
Yes.
There he is.
Yes, Shecky!
They provide the food for our coaches' party, which is the annual first Saturday here, and everybody went home well fed. And we, you know, it's outstanding contributions like that that help keep us going. Host organizations had you know, five great games with great parties afterwards. We had the Bucks and Danny Markley. Thank you very much. Great party at the Greensboro. The Bays with Bean. I know she's here someplace. Thank you very much. Great job there. Crofton with Amy Newell. I don't know if Amy's here. That was a great night. We had Chris Kelly with DAA. I think he's home with, unfortunately, Eliza had the flu tonight and had to miss the friendship game. It's a shame, but DAA put on a really, really nice event for us, and we sure missed Eliza tonight. So thank you, Chris. And also, little Jeff Bunker. St. Mary's Annapolis a great game, great night with the food. And also Jeff was very instrumental in helping us with a lot of the field logistics and everything else. And, Jeff and his St. Mary's organization, the lacrosse organization that he runs, have been good friends for a long time, and we're thankful that that relationship has continued. So thank you all for that. The kids have a lot of fun where they're here. Well, so the adults, and certainly the Metro coaches and Huggy Moms, which Cat Spence, Sir Ian Ritchie, Karina Eaton. We've had a lot of fun here, and it's great to have them here. Can't leave out the tour directors, Tony and Michelle Malkin, who we've been associated with for decades now, and I'm hoping we have at least a couple more years. So, the crossover coaches and Huggy Mom. Once again, best people in the world. Danny Ellis, our coach and trainer. Susan Fortner, Huggy Mom. Kelly Scott, Huggy Mom. Scott Samaglia, coach. And Danny Markley, coach and in charge of entertainment at any given time. We have our stateside liaisons that have been with us for many, many years and helped us in so many different ways. Don and Karen Harrison, thank you very much. And I have to thank my wife Heidi, because without her patience, I never would be here. So.
What a 2 weeks, like a roller coaster. It's been a lot of fun, it's gone quickly. And down to you guys, the hosts. Same as it was a year ago in England, but it's you guys who make it work. And I'll just back up Steve's comment about all the hospitality we've received around the county. It's been great, we get spoiled, the girls get spoiled, they love it. And we've just had the best time, we really have, all the way through. And it's so nice to be back on this field. Been here many times, I have. Girls tonight, well done. It was great lacrosse, it really was, nice to watch. And the whole thing is about the friendship, but it's about development in lacrosse, and from our point of view, the girls, this is where you go forward. After we will see them at every level in lacrosse going from here on, coaches and the Huggy Moms and Michelle and I absolutely love seeing you on the field in 2, 4, 8, 10 years. Girls who've gone to Australia just recently to play for England, preparation for the World Cup next year. 4 girls from this programme were on that, and that's where we hope to take them all. In the group we have, it's a 2-year programme as you will know, or beginning to realise. So we've got some girls here who've been with us 2 years at least. One girl has been 3. And what I'd like to do is those girls who are completing their second year, would you just stand up? Those girls who are completing their second year. hosted and their families hosted, you guys who were over, your daughters who were over last year. And did you have a lot of fun in England?
Yeah.
You did. And it's great. And we've done the 2 years with you. It's fabulous. Thank you very much. So that means that this year, as we built up, and it started last September when we invited clubs, our clubs, to send in their nominees, very much on the same basis that Steve asked here. It's about commitment to their organisation, the commitment to lacrosse, belief in themselves, belief in the team, and probably the third or fourth item in that is their lacrosse playing standard, because it's about sportswomen that we're actually looking for. And so all the girls who came in this time were nominated on that basis. So all the girls are in their first year, would you stand? These girls and their families will be hosting, should Steve and I decide to continue into next year, and Michelle and I, and we just talk about it and discuss, should we send an invitation? However, these girls would be the girls and their families who are hosting, plus our intake next September. So we end up with roughly 2 age groups. So, well done girls, you're a joy, and I'm looking forward to working with you. And no Molly here. Thank you. And I'm going to hand over to Michelle.
I'm going to continue on with the thank yous. We'd be remiss in thanking the Anne Arundel leadership team. We've got Steve, of course, and Susan, Danny and Danny, Kelly, Todd, and then Karen and Don. Thank you so much to the Anne Arundel girls for opening up your homes to our girls and sharing your space with them over the past 2 weeks. And we look forward to seeing some of you come over next year. Host families. Tony's already said it, Steve said it. We couldn't do this program without you. And I'd just like to thank you for keeping our girls safe and for providing them the time of their lives. Now, parents, I would like to also congratulate you for making the decision to put your daughters in the crossover program. A lot of lacrosse opportunities are out there for your girls, and what you've provided your girls is bigger than lacrosse. They may or may not have a long lacrosse career, but if they do, there is life after lacrosse. Now, I can give you a lot of examples of alumni from the program that have gone on to do big and great things within lacrosse. But lacrosse ends. And then you go on and you've got jobs and careers and families, but you still have the memories. And you've provided your children with a cultural exchange as well as lasting friendships through lacrosse. To the girl, don't be sad. When you say so long, it's not goodbye. You could have friends for life here. And take a look of all the alumni that we've got that have had friends that they still are in contact with 10 to 20 years later. That can be you guys. So too, Steve and Tony, our leaders, Ian, Molly, Serena, Kath, Anita, and my daughter Penny, who's stateside, who helps us every year when we come over. And to the crossover leaders, thank you. And to the hosting families, congrats, and thank you for making the choice to support and provide this experience for all of our girls. Thank you very much. Over to you.
the opening welcome ceremony this year. I know all of you weren't there, but these young ladies told a pretty cool story, and I was wondering if you could tell it again.
When we were like six, it was a tall, and then we were getting cakes or something, and then we turned around and he was there, and then he said something, and he gave us some badges, and he said that he was cool. And then
what happened? One of you lost one though, right?
Yeah, no, that was me. Sammy and you guys have something to Harrison would like to come up here and tell you a little bit about award, what it means,
how it came about. John Harris.
Thank you for getting all choked up here. Maybe I'm going to do it. Every 2 years, I get the best job in the world on tour, and that's not coaching, that's not socializing, that's not keeping score, and that's not hauling the water jugs around, and that's giving this little short talk about Lynn Jones. Lynn passed away in 2003. She stayed with us when she came over as a Huggy Mom in 2002, and then we also saw her before she passed away when we were over there in 2003. Lynn was the quintessential Huggy Mom and behind-the-scenes helper. All of you out here who do that type of work, and I know there's many of you who don't, who aren't a coach, who aren't doing anything that gets any notoriety or publicity, but you're the kind of person who makes all this sort of thing go, both here at Crossover and in the rec leagues that you're part of. Lynn did all those same kind of jobs for the Meller Club. She always had a smile on her face. She was absolutely a delight and a wonderful person to be around. I know there's not really that many people here who remember her, but I know everybody behind me does, and we miss her tremendously. A couple little stories. Lynn took a delight in just about everything here in the United States. The year she was staying with us in 2002, I had to buy a new car, and she just loved going out to the dealership with me and helping me pick out the new car. For some reason, she seemed to be fascinated with things on the American road. Every time an 18-wheeler went by, she got very excited. I think I did send her an 18-wheeled model the year after she came by. And you know, whenever I'm watching a TV show from England, and I see some of those pint-sized lorries that's over there that you guys, call commercial trucks, I always think of Lynn, because she would always complain that we don't have anything like this over in England. But Tony said to me a day or two into the tour, it is amazing how we don't see each other all that often, but we can pick right back up into this, and it's like no time has gone by at all. I know Ian Ritchie has stayed with us this year. I hadn't seen Ian since 2009, but same old Ian. I'm carting him around Anne Arundel County. He was carting me around Stockport and Meller. And I know if Lynn were to walk in here today, she would pick up as if no time had gone past. So let's all raise a glass if we've got one to Lynn Jones.
Okay, now the award. The captains will make the announcements of who they've chosen.
Thank you. All right, thank you.
drive somebody else today?
I don't know. I mean, we have an album about the bus or something.
Okay, have you thought? We've been considering inviting them back, and I just hold this envelope because it's a bit of a joke between Steve and I, because like a Tolkien story, the crystal we had, which was the transfer between us and the invitation back, got lost. By Lord of the Rings, it was lost. And accordingly, Steve actually put in place a gift, which is a clock, and the clock time is set to English time. So Steve, through this, we'd like to invite you back to come up to London next year and bring your team, many of your leadership team if you can, and we look forward to seeing you there.
Thank you very much. Tony left out the part that one year he just gave us a handwritten letter. Which he had in his hand. I think he was loving it. So thank you. This is the official box.
We have a gift for you.
We do.
Sometimes it's kind of nice to give the tour director a gift that maybe is something that he can relate to. So if you would like to open this. So
okay. Can we open it here?
Oh my.
It's kind of a with the Robinson's Brewery theme.
I've always wanted to go to one of these places. I believe there's a little gift exchange that will go on here. So, ladies,